Welcome to BusyWorksBeats.com. Today we continue the live stream here right at YouTube.com/BusyWorksBeats. I'll let everyone take a little to file in here just to make sure everyone's accounted for. So today we're going to be making commercial style hip hop. This is more freeform hip hop to where we can bring in different genres. We can bring in different vibes. I'm creating this for my own work actually. So that's why I'm showing you how to do it and how we're going to create it. So firstly, what's going on, AT? Pitler is here. Beat 003. Andres is here. Forgive me if I'm saying that wrong. What's going on? So today I want to show you what's up, Nishad Roy. How's it going? Monoliths in the building. Low cuts. No name needed. I like it. Benjamin. Young Trey is here. What's going on? Sharik is here. Jake Herrera. I am King Seuss. Welcome. Tyson. Alejandro. Young Will. Welcome. Welcome. Now it's going too fast. Cian. Igus. I do appreciate you for joining us. So I want to show you how to make that commercial hip hop, the stuff you're going to see on VH1 or during the car commercial or during some kind of promotional ad. It's a little bit different than creating beats because beats have an intro, they have a hook, they have a, you know, a verse, and there's all these parts to it. When it's more freeform, you have a lot more creativity as far as how to bring in transitions, how to bring in different stutters, whatever you want to do. So let's I'm creating my own idea for my own production, actually. So I want to show you the ins and outs of how to go about that. So firstly, I have a crowd chant. This is going to be the source. What's going on, IDK? Welcome, everyone. This is going to be the source of the song. So I want to link that up to the grid. So instead of doing all these long steps, I'm just going to grab the sample, drag it into the playlist. And I'm going to do it the old-fashioned way. Let's pull it over. Now, it looks like it's almost stretched. If you zoom all the way in, let me close out the browser for you. If you zoom all the way in, it looks like it's stretched, but it's just not there. So what we're going to do is go to snap to grid none. And then we're also going to go to our audio clips tab so we can manipulate the audio clip functionality. We're going to put that on stretch. So let's highlight stretch and let's left click the end here and just pull it over just a tad bit. Now you can see it fills in all the way. Now let's change our snap to grid back to bar mode and let's take our audio stretch mode off. That way when we move the clip, we're not stretching it anymore. We're just elongating the clip. Now let's see if this even fits the tempo. Let's go to playlist mode. It's a little loud, so let me turn it down. It's a little on beat, but we can also chop it if it gets too, you know, off beat. So let's repeat this. This is going to be the core of the sound. What I want to do is like build up a crowd and then do some type of change up to where it leads to different arpeggios and different things. So let me write a couple notes, actually. Go back to the channel rack. Let me write a couple notes. I want to have a swell. I want to have an arpeggio drop. So I'm going to put arp drop. I also want some type of FM, you know, like build bass. So I'm going to put FM build bass. Might not make sense right now. So those are the things I need for sure. Everything else is just creative. So that's the core of the track. So let's turn that down. It's super loud. That's going to act as like our hi-hats. So we don't need hi-hats right this second. Also, what I want to do is control the volume of that audio clip. So let's right-click on the purple tab, which stands for the audio clip. Let's right-click, create automation clip. Now, the original is just the sampler. This is an audio clip. It's a little bit different. So let's go back to the playlist. I want to right click, copy that initial value, and just pull it down and make sure I paste that initial value in the end value. So it builds up in volume over time. Then we could have it drop at bar 4 into some kind of arpeggio thing. So let's build the arpeggio. I'm going to build it a little bit different than most people. So let's go to Omnisphere. I want to answer your questions real quick because I know I haven't been answering your questions. Boss says, what's the difference between a beat maker and a producer? A beat maker is one who makes beats. That's as simple as it gets. A producer is one who brings a vision from a client and makes that real. A producer can handle hiring musicians. They can hire beat makers. They can hire artists to come in. They can hire, you know, session players. I just said that. But they're there to create the full vision, you know, hire mixing engineers. They're there to get the product done. You know, producer, the keyword is product. They're there to create a product. A beat maker is not creating the full product. The full product in that case would be a song. The beat maker is creating part of the product, which is the beat. So that's, you know, as far as definitions, that's what the difference is. We also have an article on that. I think on our Medium page. So type in BusyWorks Beats Medium, should pull up the page. Just want to make sure I'm answering your questions before we move forward. So I appreciate you giving, you know, writing in as well. What's to say? What desktop you use? I'll give you all my specs in a little bit. Okay. Make a video. I have previous videos, so type in Studio Setup BusyWorks Beats to dig in a little bit more. Sorry about that. My dude is okay. So thank you all for joining. What ARP we can use? Okay, so let's sound design an ARP. Let's go to tab A here. We're gonna start with a sawtooth. Let's turn analog mode off. Very basic sawtooth. Not my favorite saw sound, but we'll deal for now. Also want to pull the attack down a little bit more. Okay, so let's go to the ARP mode. Now, I usually like using regular saws. I don't really do much to a saw unless I want to make it really unique. Just quick, Laura says, what should I learn first? Sound design, music theory, or mixing? It depends on what you want your expertise to be. I would say music theory first. If you're trying to make beats, music theory first, because you can write music in all genres once you learn music theory. Sound design is more for later down the line, but mixing would be next, and then sound design, I would say last. But you, of course, you're going to learn it all at the same time anyway, but that's the sequential way of thinking about it. All right, so let me see here. One more question. Adam says, Game, can you make a video for when to use pads, when to use chords? Sure. Yeah, because you don't always use chords, you don't always use pads. Let's turn the arpeggio mode on. What I'm going to do is left click and drag this bar so it only allows me three notes. And we're going to put it on three octaves, and we're going to change the clock to some triplet timing. So it's 3-3-3. So it gives you a different type of sound. So let me play a chord here. Almost that Kanye sound. So we get a very different motion. One more thing I want to do is like an auto pan effect. Let me see here for the pan knob. If I can find the pan knob. Is there a pan knob here? Help, help. Where is the pan knob? So I want to pan A left and right. For some reason, I can't visualize. Oh, it's right here. Okay, let's right click modulate by LFO. Now I want the LFO to be very synchronized. So it's under LFO 1. So this is LFO 1. Let's turn it on sync mode. Let's change the rate to 1/8. So the ARP moves around. So now we have motion. So that way it tickles the ear. Another way to tickle the ear with an ARP is to pull up your release time for your sawtooth. That way it gives it a natural tail. You gotta be careful because too much tail can get a little too clawing. So just a tiny bit of tail. Let's drop this down an octave. ARP just, when you arpeggiate, it just sounds a lot more interesting because you're playing individual notes and it's harder to track what you're actually playing. So it sounds like you're playing some complex thing, but really you're just playing a nice chord. Let's just see. You know, so you got to be careful with the release tail, but that's another thing you want to look at. Let's see what else we can modulate here. I want to modulate the pitch slightly. So very subtly, let's right click the fine knob, go to modulate with LFO. This is under LFO 2. Let's change the rate here to free mode, but around 5 hertz or so. This is going to give it a slight pitch bend. Let's turn the depth way down so it doesn't. So we're not affecting it too much. Now the pan might be a little too fast. So let's go back to modulation tab, go to LFO 1. Let's turn that rate down a bit. It's a little too quick. There we go. Okay, so let's start adding effects because it sounds a little dry. We could also go back and change the waveform. Let's click here for the waveform. Let's go to classic sawtooth. Let's go through different sawtooth options. See, they give different tonalities. They're all pretty much the same. Nobody's gonna know the difference between a Hamburg saw and a. But it does give you a different tone. Let's go to effects. I wanna add some type of. Now, I already added a pitch change, but let's add some kind of chorusing or delay. I'm going to set it to BPM. And let's just crank down the mix level. So we're making the ARP have more movement. It's just to tickle the ear again. Again, you don't need Omnisphere. I'm just kind of showing you sound design ideas so you can kind of make things more animated. So I think that's it for that sound. Very simple saw sound. So let's listen to what we have so far. It's just a crowd sound. Then I want it to drop into like an arpeggio sound. I might do a quick arpeggio sound. I might do, you know, we don't know yet. So let's see what it sounds like when we drop it in. And I definitely want it to drop into an 808. So it's a little slow, so let's go back to the ARP. I'm going to turn down the delay. I don't want it to linger on. And where is the ARP tab? Let's make that faster. 1/64th triplet. And again, if it's too much tail, you can always turn off the effects. So, yeah, I think it's just too much effect. Let's turn that off. I like my ARPs very dry. So. Okay. So let's come up with the chord we want to play. I'm just going to play A minor. I mean, it's very basic, but that's what I want. And I'm going to show you. So that's A, C, E with two octaves of the bass. And I'm going to play it very short. I don't want to hold the ARP. So it just kind of hits and then stops. That way it tickles the ear. We're like, what was that? You know, it kind of scares us almost. Let me extend it just a little bit more. So you can see when you're doing stuff for film, it's not, you're not like trying to make it into a song, so you can be a little more creative as far as what you do throughout the track. Not sure you've done this with live streaming. Yeah, we'll do feedback eventually. We're trying to figure out a better schedule. It's easy. Thank you for your request for XXXTentacion. Let's pull it down an octave, control down. There we go. I like that octave. I need it just a little more gritty. I might change up the sawtooth. I like this saw better. Just gives me a little more bass. Okay, so what I'm going to do is EQ in a little boom. Let's pull up an EQ. Just going to use a low shelf. Just going to pull up that bass. But again, you got to be careful because we're going to bring in an 808. I'm going to distort it. Okay, now let's see what else we can bring in. Maybe strings. Let's go to east-west. Had to make sure I have my eye lock in. Let's go to Hollywood strings, and I'm going to pull up some ensembles. So again, this is from soundsonline.com. East-west offers a monthly subscription. Let's go to full strings, long. Let's go to, I always pick the first one. There's so many articulations. You know, you'd have to sit here and load them up to hear them. So it just takes too much time. So I click on the first thing most of the time. So as that's loading, let's grab an 808. Now, of course, it's coming from BusyWorksBeats.com. We just released the 808 Science Drums too. So we're going to use those 808s. And you can find them at BusyWorksBeats.com/808. Now, let me see here which one I want to use. Let's use 808 booming. I like that. Because it already has punch. And if I need to saturate it to make it more aggressive, I can. So let's right click, go to edit. See what key this is in. Let's go to the marker tab. Go to detect pitch regions. This one's in the key of C, so we don't need to tune it or do anything. Now we just have to figure out the bass line that we want to use. Let's right click, go to piano roll, and let's see what we can do. I can't speak German, unfortunately. So what I like to do with 808s is use a lot of octaves. That's just my thing. So let's start at A6 and let's work our way down the octave. So I want to or something like that. Now the 808 seems like it's coming in a little slow. I don't know if that's because the sample is too fast. So what I'm going to do is go to snap to grid none, highlight all the sample, and just hit shift right just a little bit. Or I could just zoom in and look at the transients. So the transient is the sharper part of the sound. You can see in the beginning, the sharp part doesn't really line up with the grid. So there's a little gap between when the sound actually kind of hits to its peak. So what I'm going to do is actually pull the beginning of the sound back a little bit and then pull the whole sound over so that the sharper part of the sound comes in. And you know that annoying kind of gap at the end, I'm just going to manually cut out the X. Now sounds like it's not really stretched properly. So let's go back to Control Z. This is why I say a lot of film stuff is free form, so we might have to move the drum patterns a little to the right. Let's just worry about what notes we want to play. Let me turn off the crowd for a second. Because we want to measure properly. So what we're doing subconsciously is using that crowd as a measurement tool. I want to use the metronome to know exactly how. Let's hit Control D. Seems a little slow. Turn up the BPM a little bit. It seems a little slow. Now, since I changed the BPM, when I already changed the audio, you're going to have to go back and restretch the audio because we're in a new BPM now. I think that BPM fits a little bit better. So we got to restretch the audio. So it's a lot of tedious things, but let's go to Snap the Grid None. Make sure we're zooming on in. And let's make sure this stretches out for the full. Okay. I don't know if it's the sample. I think it's the plugins on my mic. Let me turn these off. I found that usually is the case. So plugin delay compensation is one thing that you might not even know is going on. What happens is certain plugins lag the project and it makes certain sounds sound lagged. So it morphs the way you produce. So you got to be really careful with plugins. I wish they had a better solution for plugins, but I think it's just, maybe it's the sample. Who knows? But it does seem a little lagged for whatever reason. Not sure why. Maybe it's the crowd. So let's move this crowd around. These are the little tiny things that you really got to take care of. But let's move the crowd a little to the right. It's better to have it lagged than to make it hard to understand where it's coming in on the transient, because it's going to make everything else perceive as if it's trying to line up with that thing. So if you move it to the right, I found that's the quick solution for timing. Let me just start at A4 instead. Let's see. Okay, now we need some musicality in here. So let's add some synths, add a melody. Let's go to Omnisphere. Now I'm only using Omnisphere because I think you like this plugin. I mean, we've heard back from you and Omnisphere has a lot of sounds that you like. So let's open that up. All right, and let's go to synth poly because we want the option to play multiple notes at one time. Can I hear you? I can't hear you. Use Slice X, please. I don't have anything to use in Slice X. There's nothing to slice, but thank you for your request. Let's go to types, analog classics, hit random. That way you go through more sounds in Omnisphere because it has over 10,000 sounds, I believe. There's infinite options. So I like the sound. Let's create some type of repetitive melody. Remember, this is for a very short ad. So we need something that kind of just keeps people engaged. We're not looking for something that's very elongated. Also, you're trying to keep people locked in. So repetition becomes your best friend here. You don't have to come up with a Beethoven melody. But this time I want to go up the scale. I'm going to use fifths here, so A, E, A, E. Then I want to use a half step to make it more trap-like. And let's do fifths for F, so that'd be the one, let me see here. Where are we at here? There we go. too much reverb, so let me turn off the reverb or pull it back. Only thing about Omnisphere, sometimes it sounds a little plasticky. So that's because of the sustain functionality. So sometimes I like to just turn off sustain and give it a decay curvature. I'm not going to be so particular right now. When did I start making beats? If you want to learn my story in full, no, my tutorials are not on anything else except BusyWorksBeats.com and YouTube. EWTK says, when do you start making beats? How did I learn? Mentors. Somebody who's not famous, but he taught me. Oh, thank you. Salton actually answered the question. But I started hardcore focusing around 3.5 years ago. So you want to just get focused. That's the key. You got to get focused or else you're just dabbling. Yeah, I like ethnic kits a lot, especially for the more Pharrell-influenced music. Now, one more thing I want to try here for the melody is to drag the notes out so they overlap on purpose. Now, it's a little muddy, so let's pull it up an octave, hitting control up. And it's a little, I don't like that sound overlapping. Now, we're going to go down instead of upward, so we went up using fifths, down using fifths. Now we're going to go down using fifths and then change it up again. Then I'm going to use F again, but going upward. So it's, here's the pattern. We're going up a pattern, down a pattern. Then we're going down a pattern and then up the same pattern in reverse. So you can start to see there's patterns in music. Oops. F. You know what I did? Let's do it this way. Let's do C instead of A sharp. I might change the sound. It's just too plasticky, mainly because of the sustain. It's like if I turn off sustain, give it a decay curvature for both envelopes A and B. And give it a little release, it's going to sound a little more, you know, more appealing. Now let's try an effect called Gross Beat. Let's open up Gross Beat on track 5, which is the melody. Let's right click, go to momentary. I didn't know this for a long time. There's presets for Gross Beat. So hopefully, let's see. See, Alex says, how to connect notes from the end of the piano roll to the start. From the end of the piano roll to the start. Hit Alt-L. Alt-A-L-T plus L. It's the articulator functionality. Now, I didn't do anything here because they're already articulated, but, you know, that's how you do it. Or if you mean like a note right here to the end, FL doesn't know where your end is. So you have to manually drag that last note out because it could go on forever. There's no end to it. I might change the sound. It sounds a little, let's swap the sound out. I do like that sound, so let me mark it. But I don't think it has the right tone. I like that one better. It's a little more Mike Will made. Let's go to Gross Beat and let's turn on the half speed. Let's pull it up an octave, however, because it pitches it down. I like that sound. It sounds really 80s and I love that era. So let me pull down the mix level. And if you pull the mix level, you can actually have it slowed down and its regular speed. So you get to combine the two. I saw a couple questions in here. Rohit says, what's the difference between commercial and non-commercial? By commercial, I mean like advertisement commercial. That's what I mean. Not like a song. I'm using what I would naturally use. I'm not holding back on any VSTs. Fatal says, do you recommend going to Full Sail University? Well, we have students who've written in, who've graduated and taken classes there and say that they've learned a lot quicker at BusyWorksBeats.com in our course material than at university level. So, you know, that's from them. That's from their mouths. How often do you use Gross Beat? I use it a lot. I love it. I know. Okay, so I'm looking for questions. Hey, BusyWorksBeats, how long does it take before you learn the number system? Once you learn the chord codes, it's extremely quick. I mean, once you know it, you know it. But go to BusyWorksBeats.com/music theory to learn more about that chord code. How to sell beats. That's something I can't answer in one fell swoop. I had the problem today that when I started recording, that one pattern doesn't play, so I can't hear the sound while recording. How do I fix the problem? Wait, I had the problem today that when I started recording, that one pattern doesn't play, so I can't hear the sound. Not sure. You would have to write us an email at busyworksbeats.com/support. We'll figure it out. Okay, so I got to get back to the track. We'll do feedback eventually. I can't guarantee anything. The problem with feedback on YouTube is because when you copyright a song, SoundScan runs through YouTube and it marks it as a copyright thing. And you can't have a bunch of copyright things on your channel on YouTube. I think we need some drums in here. Let's. We're trying to make this like weird sounding to make people want to know what music production is all about. So the crowd, I'm actually going to add a low pass filter and do some things to it. So I added a resonance point there. You can see we only have a little patch, but it's a moving idea. It's no like song structure to it. Let's grab some percussion from the Native Instruments Battery Library. That's what NIBL stands for. Samples, drums. I like the wooden percussion, the very light percussion. I just want like boom, clap, 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 something like that. I might use, actually, let's go to snares. They have a nice snare rim shot. Let's find something that fits this vibe. I need something short but bright. Let's see what we can find here. Like this one. So I'm gonna add it right before it wraps up. Boom, clip, you know, boom, clip, you know, right before the end of the pattern. So let's add that in context. Let's swap out the sound. I like the Miami rim shot. We can barely hear anything, so we need to start leveling. Stuff's too quiet. And for the 808, I wanted it to be a little more saturated, so let's add decapitator here. Let me answer your questions again. Do I know cymatics? I know of them. Do you have any drum kits out? Of course, go to busyworksbeats.com/products if you want to see everything all at once. But I would actually suggest going to each individual page. But if you want to go to everything at once, there you go. Do I teach piano courses? As far as learning music, music theory comes before learning piano. So go to busyworksbeats.com/music theory. Now, if you have the music theory essentials, learning piano is about muscle memory at this point. So if you just learn those techniques. Okay, so we might have more on that. How are you able to stream with such clarity? Technology. Are these BusyWorks Beats drums? Yes, they are. Except the Native Instruments. This music is going to be better. Okay. Trying to get to questions and kind of keep it to where I'm answering your questions so you're not just like, hello. But also, we got to keep it moving too. So I never use taxi. Let's add a compressor to this synth. I want it to be very even. Let's add, this is a general compressor. I like the impressor. Pull my attack to zero. Make sure it's capturing the whole sound. So let's just pull it down another octave, control down. So we want to make it like modern hip hop. We're not trying to make it too 80s-ish. Leave your questions for the end. That way I can just do a quick Q&A at the end instead of like breaking the... Now it's a matter of like what kind of drums and what else do we want to add to it. I might do something like plap, 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 tat, 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 tat. I might just do that with the snare. Make it more of a, I'll show you in a second. I also want to add a super saw bass line in here. Now the snare is a little too fast, so let's go to the wrench tool, turn up time shift just a little bit. The snare is also not sharp enough, so let's grab a different sample. Now let's add the vibe to it. Let's add Silent One. I didn't update it yet, but I know they have an update. Let's go to menu, initialize preset. I'm just going to use a really deep sawtooth, two octaves lower, and add voices, maybe four or more. Just detune it. Just play really low notes. Now I'm also going to turn on portamento and monophonic mode so I can do pitch bends. That's too low, you can go up an octave. I just like that dirty, gritty sound for the song. So I'm gonna add that A on the downbeat. Add that into the track. Let's see here. Again, you don't wanna have it last forever, but you want to last longer than the art. So I left that mute in there. Excuse me, mute in there to add groove. Let's start leveling though. Everything's trying to be. Trying to think of how we can make it explode again. Now I kind of forgot the checklist, so we need a swell in here. So let's grab a white noise swell. I have one at busyworksbeats.com in the, hold on, let me get to your questions. So shout me out. Thank you. I'm not sure how to pronounce your name. Awesome Jess one. Thanks, Android. Unknown says, is there a big difference between commercial and themes? If yes, can you make a tutorial for themes later on? Not sure what you mean by themes. If you're talking about the musical term theme, or do you mean a theme for like a party? Not sure what you mean there. What are my dreams and aims? I mean, you reached everything. I didn't reach everything. It's a lot more coming. I don't like to publicly say my dreams, but there's a lot coming. Okay. What could you be teaching in premium course can to tell us briefly? Premium is about, it'll be more distinct later, but premium is more for those who have taken our courses already. You want to start with the course material first, the busyworksbeats.com/products before you even get into premium. Okay. What to keep in mind for the program? Okay. I can't make this a Q&A because that'll kill the vibe. So I got to keep moving. Let me add a transient processor to the snare, make it a little bit sharper. I want to make it aggressive on the attack. Let's lower the release so it shortens out the snare a bit. Let's turn that saw down a bit too. So now we need to make it explode again. So let's look for that swell. We're at busyworksbeats.com. I think in our X drum kit, we have this. Is it here? Not in that one. I think it's the Ultimate Producer Bundle 2. If we go to the Fire Drum Kit under Effects, we have Noise 1 and Noise 2. This is a build, a noise down. This is a noise up. Let's right click, open a new channel for each of those. What I need to do for the noise up is time stretch it to the grid. Show you how to do that real quick. So noise 2 is going in reverse. We need to go to mode, E3 generic, which is similar to tonal in previous FLs. So we're going to right click, go to 2 bars. So it builds up for 2 bars. Now we're just going to add that into a pattern and make sure we put it 2 bars ahead. And we're going to drop into white noise. Do I have a piano kit? No. Still need a little more aggression, so let me go back to the 808. I think I added decapitator but never cranked it, so let's crank up decapitator. That adds a little more aggression to the track. Very subtle. Let me loop the section so we can kind of get a vibe. So we still need something that kind of grows over time. So I said I was going to create a FM build bass. Let's do that next. Okay, did that crowd? Okay, let's open up FM8. So the way I think about this is I'm going to use an envelope to manually line up the FM sound, but you have to do it manually because it's not going to fit sync to the grid. That doesn't make any sense to anybody who's a beginner. This is way advanced, so don't worry about this if you're just beginning. So let's crank up the F output to 100. Let's turn on operator E by right clicking. Let's send it to operator F. Now what I want to do is modulate this level knob. So to do that, I'm going to set my max level of E to 100%, but what I'm going to do is tell it to have an envelope. So it doesn't go to 100%. It goes from zero, gradually goes up to 100% over time. And that's how you create those wobble sounds. So let me play a note. Okay, now we're just going to shape the ending here, make it a little more convex. So it goes wow. Now it looks like you can tempo sync this, so that's great. So let's tempo sync it. Now that sounds kind of cheesy, so I'm going to fix the sound in a second. Let's go to F. Let's pull it down a half octave. Let's go to 0.5. And let's actually go to 0.25. So it's more of a, that type of sound. So that whoa, and then it just, so we're adding the note A right before the turnaround. Very subtle, but it's gonna add attitude to the track. Make it a little more aggressive. Thank you, Evans. Let's go to effects, or we can go back to the operators and just make it self oscillate. So F is going back, feedbacking into E. So that's how you add distortion without distortion. See, it sounds a little more distorted now. Now as far as that little click at the end, you want to pull over your release tail. Now I wish they had better envelope control, but that's just how it is right now. We're going to add a little tiny release. Make sure we zoom out. Also for F, you want to give it a little release tail so it's not so like, and then stop out of nowhere. Now if you want to make it wider, let's add some effects like chorusing. Let's go to Fruity Chorus. Just to keep it native. Of course you can distort it further, but we don't need that much distortion. Now I want like another melody, like a piano melody. So let's go to Nexus for this one. Let me answer your questions real quick. Since is for commercial, does the track need to be exactly 30 seconds? everybody's format's different. You just want to have it so that they can chop it in the, you know, if in the case that they need stingers and different things. But is it bad spending too much time in the lab? I've been making a lot of songs more from sound experiments than the ones I actually had in my head. I found that discovery plays a key role in creation, so continue to discover new things. Love your work. I didn't get to read that. Sorry. Thank you. My version of FL is not allowing me to add folders. You want to wait? Let me see. You want to look at the video "Import Sounds BusyWorks Beats" into YouTube. Go research that later. Import Sounds BusyWorks Beats. Thing about free VSTs and stuff, it really causes a lot of problems sometimes in the computing side. Should I get Music Theory first or Melody Magic? Because I struggle with both. Music Theory should be first. Music Theory in a day. Melody Magic and Chord Magic are extensions of Music Theory in a day. So if you don't understand music at all, you need Music Theory in a day, because you're not going to understand Melody Magic or Chord Magic, because we use language from Music Theory in a day. You can sample songs with the standard YouTube license. Da, 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 da. Okay, sorry to read off, make this a Q&A, so I got to keep pushing, but try and keep your questions, you know, for later in the stream. But I do appreciate you asking. Maybe I'll do a Q&A next, just so you can get your questions out there. Let's add a piano in here. I'm going to add a dance piano. It's very harsh. So I want to add a little spooky. And again, very quick notes, you know, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, that type of thing. But if it sounds cheesy, let's see what it sounds like first. So we're playing F major 7, but in an arpeggio style. Sounds kind of cheesy. So let's just stack the A's so it's... Crowd's going like, hey, you can hear too much dynamic. So let's add another compressor to make it less up and down with the volume. So I'm compressing it a lot. So it doesn't like grab our attention, because that's subconsciously doing things. So let's copy the section over, but let's change what we make unique about it. So I might increase the crowd volume, something to, you know, change it. We might add another musical element. We don't know yet. So let's just crank up the volume for the crowd. Let's actually have it lead into the volume so it's more natural, so it doesn't just get louder out of nowhere. Let's just make sure we're copying these points and pasting them in. We'll try to have feedback. Now with the crowd, I also want to modulate the filter spot. So let's right click, create automation clip, so that we're opening up harmonic content as we are increasing the volume. So if you don't know what all this means, no worries. I don't want you to get confused. It's just gonna get brighter in tone, louder. And then we could drop it into like a beat real quick, you know, boom, 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 and then kind of end it. You can see when the crowd gets loud, it's hard to hear the rest of the stuff. So this is where automation, you got to make stuff go up, make stuff go down. It's a carving process. I want my snare to be a little more aggressive. Let's see what saturation would do. Sounds like the snare is a little too late. So in that case, that means the crowd is a little too early. So let's move the crowd again to the right. Sounds like they're saying game if you listen close. think we should just let it keep going. So let's do Snap the Grid beat. I don't want to do boom, 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 every single pattern. I'm going to have it more constant. Now at the end, I want the ARP to go backwards. So let me see here. So I'm going to clone the ARP patch, but we're going to have it go in reverse. Also, let's get rid of the automation here. So we're kind of working in blocks. I'm not thinking too far ahead, but I'm not thinking structured like a song either. It's the way you think about music. So let's clone pattern one. Let's make this unique. Whoops. Make that unique. Let's go to pattern two. Now what I want to do is clone this. So let's right click, go to clone. Again, commercial music's a little more freeform, so I understand it's not like a step-by-step process. This is why you need the core understanding of music theory. So let's see if we can work it backwards. Now, as played, let's go down instead. So it creates a negative emotion. Let's do that here. All right, and let me see here. What else do I want to do? We had so much stuff going on. Let me just copy everything over. Can't hear the ARP, however. So let's crank that up. Oh, it looks like, okay, I know what happened. Let's hit Control X, Control V, paste it into the new Omnisphere. So it's too much going on. Let's take something out here. Take out the snare room. I might just drag this out. Let's see. Let's drag this A minor chord out. Sounds kind of weird, so let's change it to a different timing. Trying to figure out the combination of rhythms here. This is a little more, advanced. I'm trying to keep it to 3-3-3, but it sounds a little not fast enough. Then that sounds too game-like. Wish I had something in between. That's why you can't really hold the ARP down. It sounds too game-ish. Let's just Control Z that. We have our 808. I said I was going to turn this into a trap kind of rhythm, and then we're going to wrap it out. Let's add some drums in here. Go to Ultimate Producer Bundle. At this point, I would need to spend a lot more creative time with this. You don't want to be too basic with your own brand, your own sonic branding. So let's do it this way. Let's put the snares on bounce rhythms. Now, if you don't know what bounce rhythms are, we have a video called The Most Popular Snare Pattern in Trap Music. All right, let's deal with the crowd volume, then we'll wrap it up. But you want to have different sections to where it's like, whoa. If you listen to Kanye's Power, it's like, then it goes, then they end on that long note. You want to have sections where you can end on long notes. So that's kind of what we're doing right now. Let's take out the melody. Maybe we should just end it at that point. I think it's becoming more into a beat if we start adding snares and different things. Again, you don't want to overkill. Let's take out the snare. We can definitely take out the white noise. Okay, so now we're just creating that single impact type of area. Some people call it a stinger, some people call it whatever. I call it the impact area because we're creating one big boom, and then it kind of wraps it up. And then you could cut everything from that point on. So cut the voice. Now the question is, does it give you the vibe you're looking for that particular thing? Me, it should have ended right there. So let me cut that out and then just pull that over. Now again, the human ear wants to hear things in four, so naturally we want it to kind of end at that point, 12 bars, right at the 12 bar mark. So let's create that here. Let me see, I'm just slicing out the automation so we can line it up with the grid, get rid of all the excess audio, pull the audio over. There we go. The only thing is the length of that bass note. I might make that unique, make it shorter. Snare is a little lacking, but I... Now, gross beat is continuing to go, so I'll go back to the melody. Let's right-click the mix level. Create automation clip. I want it to fully end because it continues, even though there's no notes there for the melody, it's continuing the gross beat effect. So let's turn it off at that point. Make sure it's fully off. So it only plays those four notes. Now what I'm going to do is sidechain the snare to the melody in the crowd. So let's group the melody in the crowd and in a new track. Let's call this melody and crowd. Let's actually call it just sidechain. Let's go to our crowd track one. Let's right click sidechain, go to route to this track only. Let's find our melody. Forget which track it's on. Track five, let's right click. Excuse me, route to this track only. Go to sidechain track, which has two of those tracks combined. Let's go to Fruity Limiter. Right click. Actually, not right click. You don't have that. Let's go to compressor mode. Drop your threshold to about negative 30 or lower. Ratio 10 to 1 or higher. Let's just turn it all the way up. And now we need to find our snare. Where's our snare at? Track 13. Click. Oh, that is track 13. Let's send it to track 14. Go to your sidechain track. Right click. Go to sidechain to this track. So now go back to your sidechain, Fruity Limiter. And right click on your sidechain input. We're going to click input 14. So when the snare hits, it's going to lower the volume of everything else. That way it pulls attention into the elements. Now, where is the snare? Did we take it out? Which snare? What am I looking for? Track six. Okay, pass it. Wait, I think I routed the wrong snare. That was the wrong snare. Let's go to track seven, right click, sidechain to this track. Let's go back to the sidechain, right click, insert seven. There we go. I know I'm missing your question. Sorry about that. Which Vengeance pack? This was from, I think, one of the dance. Oh, man, I don't know the exact one. Vengeance Essentials. I'm trying to go off the acronym VEC2. Something, something 2. Essential Club. I think that's what it is. Essential Club 2. Is it a bad thing to pursue music for the fame? Go for it. Influences is why music is so well known around the world. How long have you been using FL? For a long time. So I want to make that less dramatic. So let's pull up the threshold of the compressor. So it's very subtle volume manipulation, but people can't tell what's going on. It's very subliminal. I want to end on that last note on boom, an octave higher, so we know it's the end. We'll be right back. you can kind of determine the mood there. Kind of turned into more of a mysterious, the mood I'm getting from this. It's like somebody arriving, but it's very mysterious. We add an imagery. And you know what creates that mood is the low pass filter on the crowd. So we're going, yeah, 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 like we're waiting on somebody. But the low pass filter, remember we opened up the filter over time, so it reveals the crowd. So it's like, here's the person. We don't know who it is, because once we reveal the person, it ends. So that's how you have to think of music. I know it's very abstract. I'm thinking like a cologne type of commercial, something that has to do with a beach, very dark kind of setting, not nighttime, but like right before it's about to be dark outside, and a very mysterious person like arriving. So you're probably viewing their back as they're walking along a beach at night. That's kind of the thing I'm getting. This would be great for promoting lifestyle products that make the person feel really special. Like when you have something nice on, like a new suit, a new clothing, fashion, those type of things. Now, if you want to be really clever about it, you can add what's called a tag at the end, which is a little riff or some type of piano part. So you could do something like, let me pull this up an octave, just to kind of end it. You know, it's called like a tag. So let's do that since I have that in my mind. Let's record notes and automation. And let's record it for track 13, pattern 13. Okay, let's record. I wasn't ready. He wasn't ready. Turn it back. Let me see. I did it wrong anyway. Let's do it one more again. Darn, I lost my... Whoops. What am I doing? I'm gonna wrap it up after this. I'm just doing a little touch. You really don't even need this part. Okay, so I've recorded it off beat just because I have my fingers ready. So this is called a tag. You put it at the end of your thing, whatever it may be, especially for cologne or fragrance or some type of fashion. Let's clone this. All right, or some lifestyle brand. Let's copy this over, paste it in. Let's see. Let's cut that out. I'm gonna swap out the piano. That one's a little harsh. So let's go to a regular grand piano and take off the reverbs. And the goal is to land back on the root note in higher octave. I'm gonna push this a little to the right, micro nudging it. Go to the wrench tool, turn up time shift. You want to do this where it's like slow, so it goes fast and slow, or like you could do it that way, but I don't have time to show you how to time stretch and all that. So you're ending on what's called a tag, something that reminds them of the song or of the bit. So the piano could be better, but we're not going to obsess over it. Yeah, I'll do Q&A next, since you guys have a lot of questions. Q&A is next. That's the next live stream. So that wraps it up. As far as getting placed, think of this word. The definition of placement is to be placed. So if you want to be placed, you have to get around people who place people in those positions. That's how you get into placements, like film and whatever else, albums. You have to get around people whose job it is to actually find people to put them in a project. Advisors, film supervisors. they have different titles. Some people call them music supervisors for projects. You got to start getting on social media looking for those type of people. I would start at LinkedIn, not just Facebook. It's harder to find people on Facebook who are important. LinkedIn tends to have more people who are trying to display their resume. And usually it's more professionals on LinkedIn. So, just go on LinkedIn and just look for music supervisors or, there's different names, but people who place people in different places. Start at LinkedIn. So I'll do a Q&A later. I appreciate you joining me. This is just a quick over the shoulder showing you how to format, I guess. This is the most proper part. The format, especially the ending here, the tag, how to make commercial music. So thanks for watching today. If you want to learn more, I'm trying to think which would serve you best. Let me think here. We went over a lot of music theory, but as far as structure, I think you can learn more about the structure in Beat Magic. Not I think, I know you can. We go over a song structure and different things. So go to busyworksbeats.com/beatmagic if you want to learn more about song structures and different things. I do appreciate you. I'm going to get to your questions later. We got to do another live stream with just questions because it's too hard to go back and forth and stay in focus. But I do appreciate you for joining. Thanks for watching. It's busyworksbeats.com.